Do you want to know how to solder a wire together from this to this? Hey guys, in this video, I'm going to show you step by step how to solder wires together like a pro. Here are all the tools you'll need. Soldering iron for heating the solder. Electrical solder wire to create the connections between the two wires. I use a 60/40 rosin core solder wire. Wire strippers for cleanly stripping the insulation off your wires. Heat shrink tubing for insulating your connection afterward. Hot air desoldering station to shrink the tubing. If you don't have a hot air desoldering station, you can use a heat gun or a lighter. A wire cleaner to keep your soldering tip clean. If you don't have a wire cleaner, you can use a brass sponge or a damp sponge. Safety goggles to protect your eyes from any unexpected splashes of solder. If you don't have safety goggles, you can use safety glasses. Fume extractor to remove the harmful fumes produced during the soldering process. Helping hands tool to hold the wires in place while you solder. Start by grabbing your wire strippers. Strip about 1/2 inch of insulation from each end of the wire. Match the wire gauge to the correct slot on the stripper, squeeze, and carefully pull off the insulation. Strip about the same length on the other wire. Twist the wires. Before you start soldering, slide a piece of heat shrink tubing onto one of the wires. Trust me, it's easy to forget this step and there's nothing worse than realizing it too late. Move the tubing away from the area you'll be soldering so it doesn't shrink prematurely. Cross the wires and wrap each end around the other tightly. This isn't about strength. It's just to hold them in place while you solder. Turn on your fume extractor. I recommend having a fume extractor to avoid inhaling the hazardous particles from the air. Heat up your soldering iron. I set my soldering iron to around 340 degrees Celsius. Place the tip beneath the twisted wires and feed solder from the top. The solder should melt and wick through the copper strands, forming a smooth, shiny connection. Avoid touching the solder directly to the iron tip. Let the heat transfer do the work. If the solder didn't fully cover the wires, you can go over it again with another pass. After soldering, let the joint cool for a few seconds without moving it. Take a moment to check your work. The solder should cover the twisted wires evenly, with no gaps or loose strands. A good solder joint should be shiny and free of blobs or cracks. If it looks dull or rough, you might have a cold solder joint. Just reheat and add a bit more solder. If it looks solid, you're good to go. Slide your heat shrink tubing over the soldered joint. This adds insulation and helps protect your work from moisture or accidental shorts. Use a hot air rework station, heat gun, or lighter to evenly heat the tubing until it snugly wraps around the connection. I set my hot air rework station to around 180 degrees Celsius. Move the heat gun back and forth to heat the tubing. Avoid staying too long in one spot to prevent overheating the tubing. And there you have it, a perfect soldered wire connection. In this section, I'm going to solder two wires together with a few small variations. Use a wire stripper to remove about 1/2 inch of insulation from both ends of the wires. This is because the heat shrink tubing measures about 1.5 inches in length. If you cut it too long, the tubing won't fully cover the exposed wires. Slide a piece of heat shrink tubing onto one of the wires before you begin soldering. Before connecting the wires, spread the wires apart. Intermesh the wires and then twist them together. Keep twisting until the wires are fully intertwined. Use the helping hands to keep the wires steady as you solder. Turn on your fume extractor. Turn on your soldering station. Tin your soldering iron. Position your soldering iron close to the fume extractor to avoid inhaling the fumes. Heat the copper wire with the soldering iron. Place the tip of the soldering iron underneath the copper wires. After a few seconds, the wire should heat up and you can add the solder at the top of the wire. Feed the solder into the wire. You don't want too much solder. Ensure the helping hands are close to the fume extractor to avoid inhaling the fumes. Wait a few seconds before moving the wire. Move the heat shrink tubing to cover the solder area. Place the wire back to the helping hands. Use a lighter to shrink the tubing. Move the lighter back and forth a few times. I hope this video has shown you how to solder wires together. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing for more electronics tips and tutorials, and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.